All
Okay.
right, Dustin, why don't you introduce her and then we'll get going.
Okay, everybody. So our special guest tonight is Amanda Vollmer. And Amanda holds a Bachelor of Science in Agricultural Biotechnology from the University of Lethbridge, and that's in Alberta, Canada, eh? So she is a Canuck, I'm supposing. They're usually pretty cool folks, so.
Yeah.
All right, so she's got that degree and a degree of Doctor of Naturopathic Medicine from the Canadian College of Naturopathic Medicine, and that's in Toronto as well. So she also has her previous experience as a certified lab animal technician at the University of Alberta. So most of her life has been taken, she has taken an interest in botanical medicine. So that means plants, okay, guys? So self-educating on the topic many years before becoming her formal medical training. So that's what she's been focusing on is medicine. She has the experience with the animals and the plants. And currently she's authoring a book about DMSO, and that's what we were talking about tonight, DMSO, which is dimethyl sulfoxide, and I don't know what that means specifically. I'm sure it's relevant, but her book will be out in April of 2020, so
I'm
anytime
sure she's
now.
She's going to pronounce that a little bit better,
yeah.
Too. Yeah,
I just wanted to sound smart. So. Well. And so I also have her website here, so she can go into it. Her website is Yummy Mummy Emporium. So that's yummymummyemporium.org. So she's the proprietor of Yummy Mummy Emporium and Apothecary in Minden, Ontario, Canada, where she supplies all natural solutions for detoxing and healing disease. So if we, you know, in this current era where we live, there's so much junk that we just take on all the time that detoxing has to be part of your regimen. And that's a simple way to stay healthy. Without going overboard, it's just getting rid of all the junk. So I'm sure she can give us some tips on how to do that, how to help ourselves to stay healthy by staying detoxified. So Amanda, thanks for coming on the show. Tell us a little bit more about yourself, please.
Hey, thanks for having me. It's wonderful to be here. It was a great intro. I've been doing a lot since I came out of school. I mean, my whole life I've been learning and researching and always being, actually I was an artist at first, so I wanted to be an artist, and then I realized, you know, I was told I couldn't make money being an artist, which I don't think is the case, but what it did is it put my trajectory in a different way. So I started to study more of the sciences, even though I was always interested in the natural sciences. I basically was in school all the way from, you know, when I was little through till I was almost 30. And it was quite a shock coming out of school and seeing what reality was like. And I did a lot of traveling. But then after school, I had a baby and I decided to get out of Toronto because I found the city energies really intense for me. Especially while pregnant and being an empath, which is basically someone who's very sensitive to energies. And that offered me a situation where I could, I became a single mom, I could own a house and I could have a storefront in the house because in this little town that I moved into, it was a grandfathered clause. So I actually began this particular leg of my journey just because I had a baby. I couldn't find natural remedies. Like I wanted, say, a diaper cream and it was all natural. There wasn't anything in it that was questionable. And what happened is I ended up having to make it because I literally couldn't find it on the market. Even the ones that said were green at the time were still questionable. So I decided to make it and I actually loved making these natural skincare products and things. And I just kept going. And now I make over 150 different remedies. And that's where I started my business, the Yummy Mummy Emporium. And then I had this little bottle of DMSO, which is dimethyl sulfoxide. So DMSO stands for dimethyl sulfoxide. And it's from trees. It actually is an extract of trees. And it comes off of the pulp and paper industry, actually. It's like a waste product. You know, trees are held upright, they're very strong and sturdy. And then when they have to make paper from it, they use something called white liquor. And it's two chemicals put together to wash the DMSO out of it, and then it becomes pulp. And so basically it's what DMSO is what makes trees strong and upright. And then another industry takes that and just cleans it up basically and then it can be on the market for all kinds of things, including industry. So I had bought a little bottle of it because in naturopathic college, we only learned about it for, in sports medicine. So you'd have like a footballer get hit, come to the sidelines, and one of the coaches would, you know, rub DMSO on his injury and they go back to the field. And, but I thought, I'm not going to do sports med. I'm just whatever. I don't care at the time. And then I had an experience with it where I used it on myself and it was so powerful. It was such a, an intense sensation. I was like, this, what is this stuff? I didn't even research it before now. And that propelled me to do research. And I read 50 studies. I couldn't get enough of what I was reading. And from there, I do a lot of health videos. And I just basically, there was, I think it was a Saturday. My store was even open. It was really slow. And I thought, yeah, I'm just going to do a video on DMSO. And it turned out that it went viral. And that was pretty exciting because I hadn't had a video take off quite like that before. And it was really, it was called All About DMSO. It's still on my YouTube channel right now. And that information got people excited because what I realized in my research is a lot of people don't know about the substance still, even though it's been around really since, well, technically since the 30s, but really the 50s, it's been known. So that really helped me to understand its properties. And then I started making blends with DMSO. So I have skin cream with it. I have eye drops with it. I make all kinds of different topical applications. That's quite incredible what its uses are. And then I got a a publisher approached me and said, hey, do you want to write a book about DMSO? And I said, sure, I can. Sure, I can do that. I'm not busy or anything. I don't make 150 products or anything. So. I did that and it was quite hard because I'm a science mind. So I really wanted to write something very nerdy and which I did. And the publisher kept coming back and saying, can you like make this into lay terms? And I was like, oh my God, I will try. It's so hard for me to think in that way. So I had to simplify all the language. It was probably the most difficult thing next to having a baby that I've done, but it's coming out end of April.
Well, we're definitely looking forward to that. That'll be something that we'll definitely promote. Now, I've got some questions about DMSO for the people who don't understand. And now that you've rehearsed bringing it down to the more simple levels for most people to understand, you know, we're going to see how well you can do these questions here. So how you mentioned that DMSO is a byproduct of sorts from the paper industry, but you know, it's healing properties. Do you know the history of how that was discovered to be actually something that could be used medicinally?
Yeah. Well, how it really came to be was through someone called Dr. Jacob, and he essentially was working in Dr. Stanley Jacob. He's gone now. He died in 2015, but he was working as an MD and a researcher, and he was doing a lot of organ transplants. And one of the properties of DMSO is that it actually affects the freezing point of water. And that's very, very important if you're going to take an organ and freeze it and not have cell damage so that you can then, you know, put it in another animal or whatever you're doing, or at least have integrity of the organ last, because crystals of ice will damage cells. If you can have something where you can still keep the bacteria from dissolving or destroying the organ while keeping the cell intact, that's important. And basically, he was in Oregon. Oregon Sciences University, and he was looking at it as a potential preservative. And this just got incredible because he realized that it is, you know, safe. It didn't damage or alter the tissues, because a lot of these preservatives and things that they use do, like even alcohols will do that, will damage the cell tissue or alter it, so it's harder to study. And he was pretty amazed that it was doing that, and he started to go into the study of it himself and talk about it with amongst other researchers and PhDs and so forth. Now there was, you know, there's a little bit of a garlic odor to it because DMSO has a sulfur unit in it. And so if you know sulfur, things like garlic, onion smell, right? I think that's one of the things I joke about is said, I think God made the most perfect miraculous substance, which is called DMSO, except for one thing, and it's the odor. because people who take it orally often will have it come out through their breath, and some even have it come out through their skin. And that's because the breakdown of it goes to DMS, and that puts the sulfur out into the body. So there's, in my book, I have different tricks for, you know, mitigating some of that. But, you know, he noticed all these principles, basically. And then he published research, and he got a lot of pharmaceutical companies interested in it because they were patenting it as a drug, as a formal drug. There were about six pharmaceutical companies starting to do clinical studies on it. But then they had in 1965, a woman died, unfortunately. What she had done is she had been on a lot of different drugs, many medications, and she started taking high doses of DMSO. And one thing with dimethyl sulfoxide, that one of its properties is that it increases the circulation of the blood, and it also increases drug delivery to the cells. So it actually can be used as a very effective chemotherapy agent because of that. But this woman obviously did not realize that, and she had an allergic reaction, but for some reason, she didn't stop taking it, even though she was having allergic reactions, and she died from it. So after that, FDA closed down everything. They closed down clinical trials. They closed down whatever. They're like, okay, let's just back off here. It was also just on the heels of the thalidomide disaster. So they were all really scared about anything new. They were not really open to more, you know, free use of it, that kind of thing. So it actually got a bad reputation, undeservingly. And as well, the media had picked up on it, and they blasted it out before really it got into this, into the journals, into the scientific journals. So it also got a bad flavor out in the world. So it really got a nasty start. And otherwise, it's a perfectly safe, it's one of the safest substances I've ever seen. I mean, even compared to a lot of botanicals, it's extremely safe. It's just, you have to understand something like that. You have to understand its usage, right? So that's really the beginning.
So I want to show you something here. So this is, have you seen this container of DMSO before?
Yes. Yes, I have.
Okay. This is what Paul sells in his store, and we're going to give it away to a lucky drawing winner tonight. So we're going to come back to some of those dangers that you mentioned, if there's anything else really to talk about on that. But if you wanted to tell us maybe, like, because you mentioned that you have different formulas, even eye drops, and it says like don't put this in your eye. So what would be a good application for this type of DMO?
So that one is DMSO cream with aloe. What does it say the percentage of the cream on it? Like it'll say it's
99.9% pure DMSO.
Yes, but then it's diluted.
Okay,
with
yes, 70% to 30%.
Oh, okay, so that's a really nice product that you have there, because a 70% topical application with aloe is actually a very common use, all around use percentage. There's quite a fine art with DMSO because it has a very intricate and beautiful relationship with water. It actually changes the way that the molecules are situated depending on its dilution. And because of that, it will have different effects on the body. So for example, a 30% solution of DMSO is very anti-inflammatory. It is the best percentage for anti-inflammatory action. If it's in a higher, it's a higher dose, like the 70%, it's really great for pain. So it's, that one is like really nice for pain applications. And it will help with inflammation as well, but it's more going to help with circulation. So it's depending on the percentage, it has different weight. You're not going to put a cream in your eye. First of all, it's just not, it's not the right, it's not, you're not going to, you would, that would not be comfortable. Don't do that. But you would have I make a saline solution, a normal saline, and I put the correct percentage. I have a 20% DMSO With vitamin C and without, and I have a 40% with vitamin C and without, and they'll heal cataracts. They help with floaters. It's quite known for retinitis pigmentosa, which is a very specific disease of the retina. There's a lot of studies done on the eye and DMSO and dissolving cataracts, removing unwanted materials, healing the eye from after injury. The only really contraindication is if they've had a cataract surgery and they have a false lens, it's not advised to put it directly in the eye, as it could, depending on the lens type, it could dissolve or damage or blur the lens. And because we don't want to risk it, we don't want to keep testing it that way. It would have to be an independent tester that took a lens and put DMSO in different concentrations in order for us to find out what's safe and what's not. So for now, we just say don't do it. But you can use it on the eye itself with the eye closed. So you could close the eye, put DMSO on, and a lot of it will go in saturated round because it's completely transdermal. And that's one of the amazing properties of it, is that it'll go right through the skin and it'll carry whatever you've put with it. So in that application, it's just aloe, and aloe and DMSO are like best buddies, because DMSO adds heat and adds energy, and aloe is cooling and soothing. So they work well together. So that's a really nice product to have, topical product.
Nice. So what are some other healing properties? Like, maybe you can get into a little bit more, I know, maybe a little more science of it, if you could.
Yeah, certainly. It's more what doesn't it do, because it's one of those panacea things that basically I've wired myself now. If anything happens, I immediately use DMSO. Basically, the only thing you don't use it right away for is if you're actively bleeding. But if you're finished, whatever, say you cut yourself, you finish the bleeding and you're clotting, then you can apply it, and it will actually help the wound heal faster and prevent infection and prevent all kinds of secondary problems like scarring. Yeah, I make a cream called Facelift in a Jar. Okay. And I mean, it does that, because I put DMSO in it and all of these very healing oils, and together there's a synergy that's produced. And because the DMSO will carry the small molecular weight products that I've placed it with, it will actually take things underneath the skin and help plump the skin underneath. And it heals. People tell me that, you know, they had scars forever and now they're gone, or they've had discoloration and those things are gone. So that sort of behavior, which is, it seems very miraculous, right? You can use it internally or externally. There are multiple different protocols. Basically, you have to be careful if you're taking it with any, if you're on any medication, because of the increased usage of the body's abilities, right, to use the medication, and you don't need as much. So oftentimes I'll say to people, well, start to come down off that medication if you're using DMSO, and you really need to learn learn about it a little bit more and learn about sort of red flags in your body if you don't feel comfortable using it. The nice thing is, if you apply it once and you don't feel that great, just stop and check with, you know, your doctor, or check with your holistic practitioner and see, you know, first of all, if you're on any medications anyway, you're just suppressing symptoms, and that's not going to heal it. So you want to change your diet, you want to change your lifestyle, and you want to work your way off the drugs, and then you can use DMSO in a really safe way to heal the body. You just don't want to use it too strong. So you don't want to put it on the body or drink it at its full 99.995% pharma grade. You don't want to drink it like that. Although I have applied it topically pure in a couple of instances in emergencies, where the person was in so much debilitating pain and nothing was taking it away. So there are cases under supervision where you can use it, like Dr. Jacob was doing that, and other doctors have done that. The problem is, it gets red, you get redness, heat, and hives, and people can freak out, and it can peel the skin and whatever, but the skin will grow back normal and everything will heal normally and sometimes even better. But for general use and advice, that's not the way to go. I would say 80% is the highest for topical, and 50% is the highest for in any orifice and drinking it as well, so that you don't burn the tissue or damage the tissue. You should never, ever, ever put pure DMSO in the eye. 50% or lower is perfectly acceptable and does the job. It will still sting and bite, and your eye will still water, and you might swear and all of that. But it will help things like the collagen to come back in the body. That's one of its claim to fame. It's one of the, it's actually technically considered a cure for scleroderma, or one of the most important medicines for scleroderma, which is basically, it can be fatal. It's a very rare disabling disease. And what happens is collagen builds up in the body. So the skin swells, their hands and face become dense and leathery. They get a lot of calcium deposits because of all the scar tissue buildup. Their joints get stiff. It's terrible. And it is, they, a lot of studies done on it have shown that at least half of people use it, or more, have excellent improvement in their histological change of the collagen. And I'm sure those other half, if they did more applications, or say, for example, added in other herbals or other lifestyle changes with the DMSO, they would see more improvements as well. It's helpful in arthritis or anything to do with inflammation and pain. So literally anything to do with pain. The only thing you have to think about is if the tissue does not have a lot of water content, like say tendons and ligaments, it will help heal those things, but there's not a lot of water in those parts of the body. So it can be slower to heal using the DMSO, just because DMSO depends on water for travel in the body. It basically does like a little handshake dance with water and switches off as it travels through the body. And if there's not an area that has enough water saturation, then it's a slower process to heal. So just be patient with it if it's something like that. Nervous system trauma, huge. Any kind of injury. We've had situations where that individual has been unconscious. They're, you know, having even issues breathing. You can apply it topically and quite consistently, and they come around quite rapidly. There was also a case of a boy who had had a torsion of his stomach, so basically his intestines twisted and became necrotic, and he couldn't eat, right? So he was starving to death. And they actually mixed DMSO with nutrients, which one of the products that I make is that. It's a nutrient-rich DMSO blend that you apply topically. And so you actually take the nutrients transdermally, like B vitamins and magnesium and iodine and these types of things. And they fed him this way. They literally fed this boy through his skin using DMSO, which is really quite miraculous. I don't know of any other substance that does something like that. And so really wrinkles, people use it, you know, superficially for, you know, wrinkles and scars and all of those things. Internally you can, it'll absorb as it's going down. So I usually suggest to use it for things like esophageal cancers, esophageal issues. It is helpful in all kinds of cancers. Lung issues, you can actually use it in a nebulizer. You dilute it starting with 20%. You can go as high as 50%. And you can breathe it into the lung tissue, and it will help remove scar tissue in states like situations like asthma, for example, and help regenerate the tissue. And you can use it over for liver disease, use it over the liver. I mean, the sky's the limit on its uses. I have a lot of it in my book.
Hey, Amanda. So I'm looking at your website, and you mentioned different types of applications. So Paul has this topical application, for which would be good for if you have like skin issues, or like you mentioned, the inflammation or pain, you get a bruise or a cut, that would be this type of application. You also mentioned having eye issues, and so you sell an eye drop, and mm-hmm. then you also mentioned taking it orally for people who maybe have intestinal issues. And your one of the products I clicked on, maybe it was the colloidal silver variety. But what it was talking about is how your this can help boost your immune system and detoxify. So can you maybe talk about, like, how can I have a good solid medicine cabinet, and how many of these types of varieties of DMSO would be practical for an everyday person, a family to have perhaps?
Well, it would be probably most economical just to purchase a large amount of the pure DMSO and learn how to dilute it and learn how to mix it with things. And in my book, I've put a lot of recipes in there, because my What I believe in is that everyone can be their own doctor, and to empower people to learn how to use these things appropriately, because honestly, it really isn't that difficult once you understand some of the principles of the body and how everything's interconnected. And once you understand the principles of natural medicine and that you don't suppress symptoms, you listen to the body, you listen to the symptom, and then you apply the appropriate support of that system, because if it's giving you a symptom, then it's trying to heal something, it's trying to do something, right? For example, producing mucus means it's got, there's inflammation. It's creating mucus to try to cool down the tissue and repair it. And you just want to accelerate that process and move it so that it's completed, rather than putting something over top like a Band-Aid and suppressing it. So I would say having that on hand. If you're not comfortable with blending for eye drops, then have, you know, that on hand, or use that every so often. But learn to mix it with distilled water or aloe vera for your topical use. It's very easy to do that blending. And then I would say you can use it internally if you want to do some good detox. It will sequester a lot of free radicals from the body. So it does help reduce what's called reactive oxygen species, or ROS. So you'll get like cells that are not complete, and they will make a free radical, which will damage other cells. And the DMSO sequesters that. It uses a system through glutathione, which is part of the liver detox system. So it has its own enzymes, and DMSO through the sulfur, lending sulfur to it, will help the body detox through the liver system. Some people I notice have problems detoxing, so you do want to make sure your magnesium levels are high when you're going to use DMSO for detoxing, or any type of detoxing that you do, because magnesium is one of those important minerals that is in a rate-limiting step. Basically, all your six or seven main routes of elimination through the liver depend on magnesium. So if you're shy on it, which most people are in a deficiency of it, then you're not going to process very rapidly or very well. And so if you're encouraging detox, you should make sure you have a good magnesium. And I like topical because it absorbs transdermally just like DMSO does.
All right, everybody, we're going to be giving away one of these aloe vera DMSO creams. So anybody who signs up during the live stream as a Patreon, so go ahead to patreon.com Framing the World and sign up as a Patreon for the channel here, and we'll do a drawing at the end. So if you wanted to start out trying DMSO, if you've never done it before, this would be a good way for you to do it with little to no investment, maybe $1 a month. You can take your chances there. Of course, this is for sale at framingtheworld.com. And Amanda's going to she has her website, and she sells the pure liquid. So if you wanted to do what she recommended, you can get the pure liquid DMSO from her website. And if you're curious to how to use it, her book is going to be coming out. Do you have a title for that book already?
Yep, it's called Healing with DMSO, and it is available now for pre-order at basically all major booksellers.
Nice. When do you think it's going to be released?
It's released on the 28th.
Perfect. Nice.
Yeah,
and I would actually love to sell it on my website. I don't know how I would be able to do that. Maybe I can just contact you and get it through you.
Contact me, and I think I just have to connect you with the publisher, and they set that up.
Awesome. All right.
Yeah.
So I have
Great stuff to have. I recommend it for just about everyone to have some of it. And the other thing I wanted to say about it is it does prevent radiation damage. So a lot of people are scared about 5G right now, or a lot of people, you know, are getting x-rays or treatments done. And if they're primed in their body before they expose themselves, it actually prevents DNA breakage from ionizing radiation.
This seems like it would be something that the big medicine, big pharma, they would be up against it, you know?
Yeah, they don't like it much.
So what is that like? How are they bad-mouthing it? What are they saying about it?
Well, what's interesting is, like, you know, it started to get out there, and then the FDA shut it down. And then they kept it shut down because there was another negative study that showed high doses of it in animals were clouding the lens of the eye. However, most of the when they stopped the DMSO, most of the eyes returned to normal, and they never really followed up on that. And they even couldn't repeat that study. So something was happening in that lab that was questionable. But all the other, you know, there's it's actually one of the most studied substances because it's actually used in FDA-approved devices. For example, it's considered a known cure for interstitial cystitis, which is an issue of the wall of the bladder. Which actually can be fatal. And the thing is, a lot of doctors don't even know about it. And so patients don't even know, obviously. And so nobody's saying, oh, you have interstitial cystitis. Here's this DMSO injectable that we do that you can use. And they're not even really offering it. So in my book, I have a section in the back that talks about all the FDA approved DMSO devices and what they've agreed to, but they don't want it out really in the mainstream because it's bacteriostatic. I mean, it has so many properties that they would lose their antibiotics about it, right? You don't even need antibiotics. You use DMSO instead. So they definitely aren't fans. They did try to shut it down. There's a bit of history in my book about the nastiness. The publisher didn't want me to go on and on about it, so I had to cut some out about there. But I am going to privately publish my the rest of the book that I wasn't allowed to formally publish. So that will come out in the next few years because I want everyone to know all the dirt.
Hey Amanda, we had a question from our chat here from Deidre Ketchel. She asked, does it help with autoimmune issues?
Yeah, absolutely. Think of an autoimmune issue as a toxicity. So the tissue that's being so-called attacked is really has something in it, whether it's a metal, whether it's a paraben, whatever that got in there, that is the body thinks is so volatile, it would risk destroying the tissue to get it out. And using DMSO will help the tissue repair faster, so you have less of an inflammation issue, get blood flow to the area appropriately, and then help remove whatever that offending thing is in the tissue. You just have to be careful to go slow. And I mean, with all of these things, you should always do a test patch on your skin first, like even that cream that you have there. Always do a test patch because you don't know, it could put you into quite a detox response, right? If you haven't done any kind of detoxing before, right? Your body might go, whoa, we're excited. We're gonna knock you out for a couple of days or something and make you detox, right? But so just go slow with it, especially people who have long-standing issues like that. But definitely it's advised for autoimmune conditions.
And also, I
And
have in my notes here that if somebody has issues with cold sores or shingles, that they could apply this topically. And is that a known certain remedy to that, or would it just put it into remission, or?
well, think about these things as they're not caused by viruses. They're actually caused by toxicity to the tissue, that specific tissue, and it's usually the nerve that's affected. And really, it's just trying to get out toxins through that pathway. If you use, first of all, DMSO topically, if you have a shingles expression, it will prevent postherpetic neuralgia. So that's where, you know, it's sort of healed, but it's still sensitive and tender. It's one of its claim to fames actually is to prevent this problem. But if you start to use it, you may actually get a shingles outbreak because it's encouraging the body to get rid of the material to detox it through the skin. I had all kinds of experiences when I first started using it of my skin opening up and dumping stuff out, like using an opportunity to get things out of the body. But if you're consistent with it, and I usually recommend using a 50% with colloidal silver when you treat herpes or treat shingles, because it also helps the white blood cell count come up a little bit more and helps the process heal without scars. And then you can finish it once and for all, and you don't get it again. So it can do that for you, where you actually complete the healing and it's over and it won't happen again. And then for applications, if you do have herpes outbreaks, applying it regularly that way and soothing the tissue, moisturizing the tissue in between, it can actually heal it completely.
Wow. So we're getting questions here in the chat. One of the questions, I'm going to jump to this one here. It is see, that what about epilepsy and seizures? Is there any known connection with effectiveness there in that area?
Well, it's always going to depend on the cause of that particular disorder, how long they've had it, et cetera. So there's a bit of speculation, but basically, anything where you're going to assist blood flow to an area is going to assist the healing of it, right? So usually for epilepsy, what I suggest is to use a combination of CBD oil and DMSO, and it will assist the CBD to get into the region because it has to pass the blood-brain barrier, and DMSO does do that, and it will carry things past the blood-brain barrier. Even if you're on certain medications and they're not getting to an area, it can assist in that as well. The inflammation and the secondary issues from having epilepsy, it can definitely help with as well, like if you fall, hurt yourself, that kind of thing. But absolutely, you're going to want to employ it and play with your doses to see what's the perfect fit for you. And it is can be case by case basis on that as well.
And one more question, and I think we'll switch gears, but the question is hypothyroidism. Is that something that has been addressed with studies around DMSO?
Yes, anything to do with the thyroid, you're going to have healing of the tissue. And so, really, with hypothyroidism, you definitely need to treat the adrenal glands because it's usually coming from the fact that the adrenal glands have not been dealt with for a long time. So you have a stress problem, and then it's starting to pull on the thyroid, pull on the thyroid, pull on the thyroid, and then the thyroid goes into hypothyroidism. But like actually one of the first things I applied was on my neck and my parathyroid, so there's four parathyroids that sit on the thyroid, actually opened up and it started expressing all this toxic matter for like almost a week. So I would definitely do paint patch over the thyroid. You can mix it with a few drops of iodine, for example, and then always though treat the adrenals. Make high dose vitamin C. You can do licorice root extract, magnesium always, and a B multi. Like those are usually the places you start with that, and it will work in conjunction. So DMSO on its own is a healer, but when you start, it's the real beauty of it, and this is where I'm really passionate about it, is when you start mixing it and blending it with things, and you get that synergy ball. That's when you get real work effects, like miraculous sorts of things.
Awesome. So I keep coming up with new questions. Could somebody who was savvy, could they harvest this themselves?
Not particularly. I mean, you have to have a chem lab to
Okay.
do it,
All
pretty
right.
much.
Well, some of these things are out in nature, and if somebody has the capabilities to do that, it would be something that maybe they could they could do, but it wouldn't be something in this case here. So
Easy,
now,
no.
some of the dangers. I don't want to end on the dangers, but are you? Do you have a chapter in your book that addresses any of that stuff? Would your book be able to go into? Is this, for the most part, something that isn't very like a high risk?
It's very, very, very low risk. It's one of the most lowest risk things out there. But with anything like this, especially when you have such a transdermal nature to it, you got to know what you're doing because it's not going to kill you. It's just you could have a situation that, is an oops. For example, I was playing with rust and I was washing rust off of something and I had rust on my hands and then I didn't wash my hands and I started to apply DMSO. And I realized I was putting, because when you put DMSO on your skin, you'll immediately taste it in your mouth. So you put it on your foot, you're going to taste it in your mouth almost immediately because it hits through the nervous system like in an instant. And so I started to taste rust. I'm like, oh no, that was really dumb. But I learned sometimes that way and it really taught me something, these types of mistakes. And so you definitely, if people say they change the oil in their cars and they don't wash their hands, you don't want to go and put your hand in the DMSO thing and rub it on your skin. You're going to take that also into your skin. So really being wise about what you're, just wash your hands. I mean, wash your hands of any toxin that's potential, then you're not going to have an issue, right? Just be sort of savvy about it like that. And it won't carry in things that are large. It won't carry in bacteria or anything like that.
Well, people in the chat are asking, where do we get this book? Can you just plug it one more time where they can order it today?
Yes, so the name is Healing with DMSO. And if you go to, say, like Amazon, Barnes and Noble, Chapters Indigo, there's one in the UK, I forget the name of it, sorry. There's even an ebook format that I started seeing about. So there's hard soft cover and ebook available, Healing with DMSO.
Awesome.
Yeah, I tried to keep it very easy to function with it. Actually, I almost did sort of a PhD because when I started to research, I got a little bit of an advance from the publisher. And so I thought, I'm going to just buy all the DMSO books. I want to read them all. I want it all, right? So I bought every English speaking one because there's a lot of ones in German. There's Germany's onto it. So I couldn't get all of them. And I basically read every single book I could get my hands on. So that's almost like how a PhD works, right? Where you get all the information and then after you do your writing. So it was, but what it showed me is it's really, there's not that much out there, really, like in the span of things. There's a lot of studies, which I read as many as I could. But there's not a lot of books, and none of the books I read had, you know, some of the history and obviously some of the uses and so forth in, but they didn't have the recipes. Like they would tell you maybe how to mix it and stuff, but they didn't have actual specific recipes, like recipes to treat toenail fungus and recipes for ear infections and, you know, recipes for animals. I have animal section in there too, because it's great for your pets. It's great for it's very safe for your animals to use. And I've used it with great success on many, many animals too. So, yeah.
So we're gonna give this away. We're gonna give one of these away to whoever wins the random drawing for and you're entering this drawing whenever you sign up to be a Patreon during this live stream. And Amanda, this one here that I've got in my hand, you mentioned so many different uses. So this would be good if somebody does have the shingle situation or cold sores. This would be good if they have toe fungus. It would be something they could apply topically to their feet or
If they had toe fungus, that all they would do is take out some of the cream into their hands and put a drop of Lugol's iodine in it, and then rub that on the toe base.
Okay, and then you mentioned also mixing with iodine if you had hypothyroidism, so that
Yeah.
this very cream would be effective in all those types of treatment.
Yeah, I mean it's 70%, so sometimes you might need a little higher, or sometimes you might need a little lower, but definitely testing yourself with it and see how you like it and what you found it helpful for. If you're using it on a spot of acne, or if you're using it as an analgesic on something like sore muscles, or you have restless legs and you want to maybe mix it with a bit of magnesium. I'm actually in the development of a product now, which is DMSO with magnesium together. To help those two absorb really nicely, and that's great for any type of muscle ache and pain and restless legs as well. So yeah, they could definitely do that.
And if you take a lot of it, bring some breath mints because they might make you have a little breath, huh? I don't know. I know when I'm sick, my wife's like hands me garlic cloves and just like, hey, just chomp on this and I'll throw back some garlic. I don't even care what people think. I'd rather. So.
It's not that bad, really. I mean, smelt it on some people, like they're off gassing pretty seriously. But for the most part, like I have a couple of people, because I do see clients, and I have a client, and she had a has a tumor on her kidney, and we've been just helping her prepare and dissolve it and stuff. She's been doing a lot of topical poultices and things, and lots of DMSO. And so her and her husband both are doing it, and they come in, and I can smell it on their breath a little, but it's not that terrible. You can use oil of wintergreen or wintergreen gum that tends to sort of knock it out a little bit. And you lose your friends over something like that, then they weren't your friends to begin with. So.
Well, it's not bad at all, guys. You don't really taste it much at all.
So Amanda Vollmer, you can find her at Dr. underscore Voll on at Twitter. She has her website here, and I lost where it is, but it is the Yummy Mummy.
It's that top one,
And
yeah.
is it Yummy Mummy? Please help me out.
Emporium.org.
Emporium.org. You can find her on Facebook also. She's going to have her book there. We've got that there on Amazon. And we just want to let everybody know that, like with this DMSO, you can save yourself a lot of trouble by finding this one thing that fixes so many. Is you got to have it in your medicine cabinet. Check out her website there. She sells it in different varieties, different types of application. So you will find what you need. And clearly, when you buy that book, Healing with DMSO. You can pre-order now on Amazon. You can take that and go through it. It'll help you figure out how you want to apply the specific remedy using DMSO to whatever your issues may be. So we just want to thank you so much for coming in and talking specifically about DMSO. So I've become much greater educated because of your sharing this knowledge.